Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today I have a great lesson for you. We are going to learn around 30 new French words or vocabulary. And I don't mean new only if you're a French learner. These words have been officially added to the dictionary in 2022. Some of them have been used for a couple of years, but they have been added only now. It usually takes some time to become official, but some of them have been used for a couple of years. Especially a few words from recent events, let's say that, from the last few years. The dictionaries that I'm talking about are Le Petit Robert and Larousse. I will add the links of where I found the words and also the links to the actual dictionaries if you want to buy them. Talking about links, don't forget that you can get the free PDF of this lesson. The link is also in the description box. It's free. You just need to leave your email and then you get it for free. After that, you're on my newsletter and you get a new lesson every Wednesday. Last point, these words are going to be included in the vocabulary course that is coming in a couple of weeks. So stay tuned for that. This lesson is divided into 5 categories. The first one, and probably the one with the most words, I believe, is Inès. With no surprise, all the events from the last couple of years have created many new words, and they are officially in the dictionary this year. Then we have a couple of new words for food and drinks, society, media and technology, and then some diverse things that couldn't fit into any categories. For almost all the words, I'm going to give you the type of a word that it is, so noun, a verb, etc. I'm going to give you a definition and then an example in a sentence. So let's start with illness. The first one is a noun. We are going to have anti-vaccin. Anti-vaccin. So the definition is qui refuse de se faire vacciner. Un anti-vaccin est une personne qui refuse de se faire vacciner. So that's for when it's a noun. It can also be an adjective. Un homme anti-vaccin. Anti-vaccin. But to make it very easy, we also have the familiar way to say it, which is anti-vax. Anti-vax. I believe it's coming from English, so it's very easy. This one is very cute. I really like it. It's called bobologie. Bobologie. It is a feminine noun. Le fait de soigner les petites blessures et les maux bénins. Ils viennent aux urgences pour de la bobologie. Ils viennent aux urgences pour de la bobologie. The reason why I find this word very cute is that in French, when, you know, a kid hurt himself, he falls and scratches his knee or something, we say un bobo, un bobo. Oh, tu t'es fait un bobo? Un bobo, you got hurt. It's a cute way to say you got hurt. So this word is very cute for me because of that. With absolutely no surprise, we also have COVID. The very interesting thing about that is that the dictionary doesn't pronounce itself about the gender of the noun. So it can be le COVID ou la COVID. At the beginning, the official person making the French language said that it was going to be a feminine noun. But then everybody started to say le COVID because le virus. So now both are correct and the dictionary doesn't pronounce itself on it. Personally, I always say le COVID as well. Il a attrapé le COVID. Le COVID. Still related to COVID and everything, we have confiné. Confiné. And we also have déconfiné. Confiné. Déconfiné. So, confiné to confine. Nous sommes confinés depuis plusieurs mois. Nous sommes confinés depuis plusieurs mois. I didn't make a definition for this one because I think the whole world know what we're talking about. So now we've seen confiné, we also have confinement. Confinement, which is a masculine noun. And we also have le déconfinement. Ils ont annoncé la fin du confinement pour la semaine prochaine. Ils ont annoncé la fin du confinement pour la semaine prochaine. Crématiser. Crématiser. It's a verb. procéder à la crémation d'un défunt. Je pensais qu'il avait été enterré, mais il a été crématisé. Distanciel. Distanciel, I found it very useless. You're going to see why. Distanciel can be a noun and can be an adjective. Let's see both. So for the noun, we have une réunion en distanciel. Une réunion en distanciel. Which basically means à distance. So we already have a term for that. So I don't really see why we have a new word, but you know, here it is. Une réunion en distanciel. Or it can also be an adjective. Une réunion distancielle. Psychotraumatique. And yes, in French we pronounce the P. Psy. Psy. Psychotraumatique. So this one is an adjective qui provoque ou résulte d'un traumatisme psychique. Il souffre de troubles psychotraumatiques. Il souffre de troubles psychotraumatiques. Téléconsultation. So, une téléconsultation. This is a feminine noun. Une consultation médicale faite en distanciel. Une consultation médicale faite en distanciel. You can see I use the word distanciel. It's there, might as well use it. J'ai ma téléconsultation à 18h. J'ai ma téléconsultation à 18h. And the last one for illness, we have un vaccinodrome. Un vaccinodrome. This is a masculine noun and I think we can all guess what it is. Centre de vaccination collective. Centre de vaccination collective. Je me suis faite vacciner au vaccinodrome. Je me suis faite vacciner au vaccinodrome. Personally, this is true for me. I got vaccinated there, and when you think about it, this is such a crazy experience to have. Now, food and drinks. The first one, we have le bao. Bao, bao. This is a masculine noun. Une petite brioche farcie cuite à la vapeur. Une petite brioche farcie cuite à la vapeur. Le bao vient de la cuisine asiatique. Le bao vient de la cuisine asiatique. I personally never tried it, but let me know if you have it. Then we have shawarma. Shawarma. Masculine noun as well. Viande épicée grillée sur une broche et tranchée en lamelles. Le shawarma vient du Moyen-Orient. Le shawarma vient du Moyen-Orient. Coffee shop. Coffee shop. This word has obviously another meaning as well, which I'm not going to talk about in this video. I'm going to talk about coffee shop as where to get a coffee. Établissement où l'on peut commander un café et manger un morceau. On va se retrouver dans ce nouveau coffee shop. On va se retrouver dans ce nouveau coffee shop. So I think this is mostly from the younger generation and definitely from English, because before we would just say un café. Au café, just like the word coffee. Coffee was a coffee and also a coffee place. We also have now the word mocktail. Mocktail, which is un cocktail sans alcool. And it is a masculine noun. Je conduis, donc je vais commander un mocktail. Je conduis, donc je vais commander un mocktail. Society. In this category, we have some very interesting words. In terms of habits and also in terms of person. The first one is déconsommation. La déconsommation. Feminine noun. So this is basically le fait de réduire sa consommation. Je vais essayer la déconsommation afin de dépenser moins. Je vais essayer la déconsommation afin de dépenser moins. In the same type of concept, we have frugalisme. Frugalisme. This is a masculine noun. Dépenser moins pour atteindre l'indépendance financière. Dépenser moins pour atteindre l'indépendance financière. Elle va se mettre au frugalisme pour payer sa dette. Elle va se mettre au frugalisme pour payer sa dette. Then we have this verb coming from the term héros. Héros. This one is héroïser. Héroïser. Faire de quelqu'un un héros. La société héroïse cet athlète. La société héroïse cet athlète. Intersectionnalité. This one is feminine. Intersectionnalité. Intersectionnalité. Concept associant les aspects qui constituent l'identité d'une personne au système de discrimination et domination. This one is a little bit more complicated than the other ones. Il a rédigé sa thèse sur l'intersectionnalité. Il a rédigé sa thèse sur l'intersectionnalité. Ok? A new verb, mitonner. Mitonner. This is a verb and it's a very familiar way to speak. Raconter des mensonges, mentir. Il a mitonné le professeur pour partir plus tôt. Il a mitonné le professeur pour partir plus tôt. So we already have that, I'm not too sure if it's in the dictionary, but we have un mytho, une mytho. As a noun, to say that person is a liar. Silencer. Silencer is a new verb coming from silence, silence. Réduire quelqu'un ou quelque chose au silence. Ils ont silencé les minorités pendant plusieurs décennies. Ils ont silencé les minorités pendant plusieurs décennies. Then we have transidentité. Transidentité, which is a feminine noun. L'identité de genre des personnes trans. L'identité de genre des personnes trans. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't really know how to use this one in a sentence. So if any of you has a good sentence for it, please share it in the comment section. The next one is also about discrimination and everything. We have validisme. Validisme. Masculine noun. Système faisant des personnes valides la norme sociale et donc discriminant les personnes en situation de handicap. Il faut lutter contre le validisme. Il faut lutter contre le validisme. Media and technology. Autotune, I'm sure many of you know it already. It's a word that is not, I would not say commonly used, but used. And I think it just came into the dictionary, that's all. So this is a masculine noun. Logiciel qui corrige les notes dans une chanson. On peut entendre qu'ils ont utilisé l'autotune pour cette chanson. On peut entendre qu'ils ont utilisé l'autotune pour cette chanson. Oxymètre. Oxymètre. I was not sure if I should put it in the first category or in this category, but I went with this one. Oxymètre is a masculine noun. Un oxymètre. Appareil qui mesure le taux d'oxygène d'un mélange gazeux ou d'un liquide. Ce laboratoire est maintenant équipé de 3 oxymètres ou de 3 oxymètres. Ce laboratoire est maintenant équipé de 3 oxymètres. If you're on YouTube, you probably know already the word vlog. Un vlog, it's a masculine noun. Simply, blog réalisé sous la forme d'une vidéo. Elle vient juste de publier un nouveau vlog. Elle vient juste de publier un nouveau vlog. Once again, about the internet, we have VPN. So VPN in English. In French, we pronounce it the way that we spell. So V-P-N. VPN. VPN is a masculine noun, un VPN. Système qui permet de sécuriser sa connexion en ligne. Cela fait plusieurs années que j'utilise un VPN et je ne le regrette pas. Cela fait plusieurs années que j'utilise un VPN et je ne le regrette pas. Est-ce que vous utilisez un VPN? Are you using a VPN? For the last one, we have 3 words that didn't really fit into anything else. So we're going to see them now. The first one is DIY. And yes, it is how we say it in French. Surprisingly, we are following the English pronunciation. So it's do it yourself. With a very nice French accent. Do it yourself. Yourself. This one is a masculine noun, so do it yourself is faites-le vous-même. Tu devrais essayer le DIY pour ton projet. Tu devrais essayer le DIY pour ton projet. The next one is konjac. Konjac. Le konjac. So this is a masculine noun. Plante d'origine de l'Asie du Sud-Est. Plante d'origine de l'Asie du Sud-Est. On peut acheter du konjac sous forme de farine. On peut acheter du konjac sous forme de farine. And pasta, I saw as well. And the last one, probably the best for the end, it's called le longe-côte. Longe-côte. This is a masculine noun. It's marcher dans l'eau le long de la côte. Marcher dans l'eau le long de la côte. So it's basically walking in water. So instead of walking in, on the beach, well, people walk in the water. Le longe-côte est originaire du nord de la France. Le longe-côte est originaire du nord de la France. That's it for today. Please let me know which one was your favorite. Mine is definitely Bobology. Absolutely love this new word. And don't forget to get your free PDF, of course. Like this video, subscribe if you haven't yet. And I will see you on Friday for a new short. À vendredi!